My name is Sheng Shen. I'm a professor from Mechanical Engineering Department at Carnegie Mellon University. My group is working on heat transfer, applied physics, material science, and nanofabrication. We are making nanomaterials and nanostructures. Nanostructures are so small, and they have a similar size with the wavelengths of energy carriers, such as photons, electrons, and molecules. So that means, at a nanoscale, the classical physical principles cannot accurately predict what happens. Our goal is to create better ways to utilize energies, such as solar power and heat, and develop more efficient energy systems. In our lab, we are making so-called thermal interface materials. Those thermal interface materials can be used to join two surfaces so that heat can be easily transferred from one surface to the other surface. Thermal interface materials have been widely used for the thermal management of microelectronic devices, such as computer chips and LED modules. Solder is one commonly used thermal interface material. Solder usually have pretty good thermal transport property because they're made from metal, but they cannot accommodate the thermal stress generated due to the thermal expansion of two surfaces. On the other hand, a lot of people use epoxy-based thermal interface materials. However, they have pretty poor thermal transport properties. So generally speaking, it is very challenging and difficult to develop a good thermal interface material with a good thermal transport property and a high mechanical compliance. So if we can carefully tailor the thermal transport properties of materials, we are able to make nanowire thermal interface materials with high thermal conductivity and high mechanical compliance. Thermal emission is one of the common phenomena we can see every day. For example, a human body emits the thermal infrared waves to the cold surroundings. So people developed infrared cameras to catch and image the thermal emission of the bodies. However, in some cases, we also need to hide our thermal signatures from those infrared cameras. So in our lab, we are working on the nanophotonic structures to control and manipulate the thermal emission from the bodies. Probably in 10 years, we are able to develop the thermal infrared invisible cloak for human being. So someday, we can probably hide from the infrared cameras. For the thermal interface material research, we are really pushing forward at Carnegie Mellon.